Can I just do a quick sound check? Can you hear me? Can you hear me in the tent? Yeah. Yes, you can. And downstairs, can you hear me? Hooray! Don't you love it when a plan comes together? Yes. Well, first of all, thank you for turning up tonight and trusting me with your evening, or trusting us with your evening. And I don't know who has actually been. I know a number of you have been here before. And I know there's a number of newbies. Both these musicians have actually both been here before, which is actually a measurement of how good they are, because if they didn't impress me the first time around, they don't get invited back. John was here a few years ago with Daryl, wasn't it? Daryl. And it was a joy when I found out that Billy, who is also playing this evening, was kind of hooked up a tour. And this is day two, or day gig two?
Day two, eight.
Not on a row, but... Nonetheless. Yeah. Anyhow, it's a combination of fingerstyle, guitar, music. You're all going to find out this in a moment, but the main thing is that we make them feel very welcome. Would you please make a big noise for Mr. John Hart? Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Okay. Everyone well?
Yes.
Can we have a hand for Richard, please? So like Richard said, we're going to have a combination of fingerstyle, classical, singer-songwriter, complete mix. So I'll do a set, and then Billy, and then we'll team up at the end. So a couple of summers ago, it's quite a few years ago now actually, about seven, I had a writer's block in midsummer, and my wife and I, we were living in a flat before we bought a house, and got musical instruments dotted all around our living room. We had this wind chime neatly placed on the windowsill. And one day, we had the windows open. There was a gust of wind, and it caught the wind chime. And I kind of suddenly thought, this would be a perfect idea to create a piece. You never know where inspiration comes from, basically. So I thought, what if I mimicked the wind chime on my guitar and then built a piece around it without being pretentious? And so I did that, and then I started off with the sound of the wind chime, and then the whole piece developed. It took months and months and months for it to come together. And I realized it was about finding peace. Especially living in and around London, where I grew up on the Isle of Wight, and then moving up to London, my blood circulation sort of sped up by 100 times. So anyway, this is called Wind Chime.
Chimes in the pitch.
heart sick somebody. Close your eye for the chime. Clock ticks by. Say, say, say. Search in the pace, fail the wind chime. Search in the pace, so close your eyes for the child. Clock ticks by. Close your eyes for the chime. Clock ticks by.
Thank you so much. It just so happens, trying to find peace. I blew a tire on the M25 on the way here, which is it can be eventful. But it was all fine. I also had my daughter's 6th birthday today, so I had 7 princesses. So I've come from quite a busy schedule today, so it's lovely to play. It's like Clark Kent, Superman kind of territory. So, I'm in the middle of writing a new album, and my first album, Reborn, which is all the percussive finger style and singing over the top and things, and I wrote that at a time where my life was generally quite calm, and I was looking for chaos in my life. So I wanted to experiment as much as I can. So I took 2 years out of my singer-songwriter life. I used to write rock pop stuff, kind of Ed Sheeran stuff, and I had like 3 albums, and then just one day I felt I was more like an entertainer than a musician. So I decided to scrap all of that, take 2 years out, which is like the equivalent of a master's degree, and then come up with this stuff. And it was blood, sweat and tears, but it was worth it. And I used to write a song like every week, and now I write every 6 months, and then just kind of builds and builds and builds. But this new album that I'm working on, so that was called Reborn. I now have quite a bit of chaos in my life. Now I'm a parent with 2 young children, and so I'm looking for calm in my life. So it's all flipped on its head. So I've decided, it was at Christmas, I got a nylon guitar and a steel string, and I write this concept album around a calendar. So I call it annual, and I wanted to write a track for every month of the year, because it will come back around every single time. And along with that month, I would name each month. So January, I've got a track called The Morning Still, and so on and so on. So I wrote this track for my wife, and it's called Sarah, and it's for June, for our anniversary. But the nicest thing about it is you'll hear the difference in dynamics and things. It's very peaceful. So this is called Sarah. Thank you. what's nice about that as well. So I became a father 6 years ago now, and then I became a father again 3 years ago, and I decided to write a song for my father more as an apology. As I was growing up, karma does come back around, it really does. And you don't really understand parenthood until you're in it, really. It's a wonderful and exhausting an experience, and I love them to bits. And just leaving today, I kind of walk away from the circus, and then I'm 10 minutes away and I'm missing it already. It's one of those crazy guilty things, it's crazy. But anyway, so I wrote this song for my father on Father's Day, realizing how much of a role model he was sort of growing up. He's not a musician, but he's just the way he is as a father, and how I am now. And I decided to write this for him. So this is dedicated to fathers here, and if you're not a father, your father. So this is simply called Father. So.
Whoa!
you've done.
Thank you so much. So as Richard said, a couple of years ago, I played at the Drawing Room for the first time with my good friend, Mr. Darrell Kelly. And that was during a time where, a couple of years ago, Darrell bought a narrowboat randomly. And he told me about this at a guitar night. And I'm very optimistic, so I pitched to him, let's do a tour. He was like, I haven't even got the keys yet, dude. But I was like, it'd be fine, I'll book the venues. And then, so it actually happened. We went from Reading to Windsor to London, but forgetting that this narrowboat goes 5 miles per hour. So we had to go 100 meters, get in a car, go to the venue, come back, do 100 meters, and it worked out like that. But every morning we have, you know, our eggs, and then we get our guitars and ukuleles out, and we write a song in the morning of the 5-date tour, and then we'd actually perform that song that night. So whatever we wrote in the morning, we'd just play it however freely, and then we'd ask the audience what we thought the song would be called. Anyway, so we went up to Scotland, we did a festival up there, and this was post-album, and I came up with the track. It was because the whole boat album was sort of fingerstyle, folk, boaty, sort of styly. And yeah, you see where we're going there. That's our USP. Yeah, that's it. And that's called Set Adrift. And actually, we did the album in, we did the tour in 5 days, and then we recorded it within 24 hours, 2 weeks later, actually on the boat. So on the actual on the album, you can hear like boat creaks, you can hear ducks in the background, all kinds of stuff. Quite magical and very, very strange at the same time, especially 20 hours into recording. We were just all over the place. But it was a lot of fun, and it inspired this next track where it's kind of going into oneself. Analyzing, and that's probably what a lot of artists do, and they strip back the layers and they find out, and I found that out through my whole new songwriting process. So, and it was fun. I wanted to try a sort of a folky vibe rather than the hitting my guitar and trying to emulate a band. I used to be in tons and tons of bands basically, and then I just got fed up with the other members, so I just try to emulate it on the guitar. That's basically what it was. So and I could come to wonderful venues like this and fit into a corner. So, but anyway, this track was a nice experiment, and it came out really well. So this is called Lost at Sea. Thank you. play a cover for you. So, when I grew up, I used to listen to music in my dad's car, which I used to think was an absolute load of rubbish, until I realized it's my whole musical DNA. So, all your Led Zeppelin and Pink Floyd and Fleetwood Mac and all those greats, yeah, I thought they were absolutely rubbish. Then I realized now, I'm like, that's all I listen to. So I'm trying to do it with my kids now. And they keep telling me to turn it off, but I know it will come back around. So, but anyway, Fleetwood Mac was one of those bands that I had on repeat. And actually, a lot of the influence with... So I have a few gadgets down here. I obviously can't sing in full-blown harmony here. That would be a lovely skill. So there's a few gadgets. And what I loved about Fleetwood Mac was not only the songwriting, but the harmonies as well. And that's why I love carrying around with it, and I have a bit of delay on my vocal. But Rumours, the album, came out about 42-43 years ago, and it's a wonderful album that my dad put on repeat when I was younger. And for their 40th anniversary of the album, I decided to put an arrangement together. And I don't do a lot of covers that flow into the original stuff, but I thought I'd give this one a go. So I won't tell you what the title is, but if you're a Fleetwood Mac fan or a Formula One fan, you already know what it's called. So.
Me again, I can still hear you saying,
We will never breathe, that you never breathe the chain.
Last night. So that's why I'm sitting down. Okay, if I can. Thank you so much. All right.
So. So, as we're in April, I thought I'd play April for you this evening. Now, April reminds me of April showers. Every time it comes round, it's my daughter's and my wife's birthday all in one month, so the bank balance is always fresh. But it always seems to rain. We're always trying to plan everything. It's going to be sunny, but no. But anyway, there's what I like about sometimes going on public transport, especially the bus. You hear two ladies who've never met each other before, but they find a positive out of a negative, which is mainly the weather. And I overheard this one day, and I kind of thought, it's a really lovely thought. And when you go on tour, I've just finished a live DVD in Italy last week. So just for that's coming out next year. Just a quick little plug there. But you kind of mention these things, and it's a very British thing. I tried to explain this into the audience, and they didn't quite get it. But anyway, I like wind chime. I decided to try and mimic rain, like the chimes on the guitar, without being pretentious, and then build up the whole track. And what's nice about instrumentals and doing an instrumental album is stepping away from the vocal, because it takes up a lot of headspace while you're trying to do all this left hand and right hand, and then I call it the triangle. But then it's just so nice to just sit back and be able to play. So I came up with this track, and it's called Reminiscent Rain, and it's going to be for April. So, and it goes a bit like this. This is called tuning, so. All right. There we go. Okay. Mm-hmm.
so you can hear, just behind the capo here. Just behind the capo here. So you've got those nice little, basically it's like if rain was hitting gutters in lots of different places. And that's kind of when I heard it first, I was like, oh. So anyway, it's a bass around that, the whole track. So, and there'll be a small storm in the middle, and then they'll have a nice eye in the storm, and then it will end lovely, so in theory. Thank you. Thank you so much. How long we got left on my set? I don't know. One? Two? One? Okay, no worries, I'll do one. Okay, so. This is one. I'll end with a cover. I'm just going to move this seat very quickly. Okay. Right. Just set up here. And I'll tune and talk at the same time. So, thank you so much for having us here tonight. And you've got a real treat coming up next. If you haven't seen him, he's an acoustic prodigy, he really is. And one of the nicest guys on tour as well. We're only 2 days in. But it's going to be a lot of fun. So, we conveniently have CDs and all that sort of stuff for sale. I do have Kids for Feed, so please donate whatever you can. Hey, hey. No, it's for art. That's fine. So, Pink Floyd. I grew up with Pink Floyd. Anyone a Pink Floyd fan? Okay, cool. So Dark Side of the Moon album, I thought was rubbish when I was growing up. But actually turns out to be my favorite all-time album of all time. Probably because it was just on repeat over and over and over. I was brainwashed with the whole thing. And conveniently, when I went to... I grew up on the Isle of Wight. And then, beautiful little place. And then I moved over to Southampton. Didn't go far to university and met my wife there. Then we moved up to London, which moving from the Isle of Wight to London was like leaving the Shire for Mordor. When I met my wife, I got together in a band and things as well, and we decided to go down to the local Royal Oak pub and perform the whole Dark Side of the Moon album, and the response was this, which was delightful. Tumbleweed everywhere. We thought we were great. But anyway, one of the tracks that stuck with me, and it still sticks with me for a long time, was Money. Now, Money is one of those, it's probably classed as the most commercial track on the album, but a track in musical terms, if it's in 7/8 and then it's got like cash registers and things as well, it wouldn't go in the mainstream world now, but it's catchy enough. So anyway, it's one of my dad's favorites as well, so I'm like, I've got to do this right. So a couple of years ago, it was Boxing Day, and I took my father-in-law's guitar and I started working this out. And I thought, right, I've got to take every single ingredient there is. There's cash registers, there's bass, the bass line, there's the Hammond organ, there's the vocal, there's, all different things as well. And I try and trace this all on the guitar, not realizing that the intro is the hardest thing to play because of the cash registers. So I'm going to attempt to play the cash registers with my right hand, play the bass with my left hand, bring in the beat, then bring in the vocal, and try and not pull that face, which is just like, oh my goodness me. So anyway, this is my interpretation of Money. Please come and say hello to me afterwards. And and if it's not your thing, just, please come and curse me. Curse or say hello, however you feel. So, but this is my interpretation of Money. My name's been John Hart. Thank you so much.
Money. cash with both hands and make a stash. New car, caviar, fast start, daydream, think about me a football team. Money, get back. I'm alright, yeah, keep your hands up on my stack. Money, it's a hit. Don't give me that do-do-do-do-do-do bullshit. I'm in a high fidelity first class traveling set. I think I'll buy me a lift. Jet.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, John. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Brilliant.
What an opening set, hey?
Brilliant.
Now, I know your heartstrings were all being twanged when you heard it was kind of raining outside and this guy's got no money in his bank account and he's got birthday covers too. You can fix that.
I laid it on thick, didn't I?
You've got some CDs for sale.
I've got some CDs and some USBs, yep.
And on USB.
Oh, yeah, we got. I got all the whole discography on a USB.
These are the wooden ones.
These are the wooden ones that we've,
John Kenzie ones.
Yeah.
Nice one.
Yep.
Listen, we're going to have a short break. I'm going to put on some background music. If you would like some cake, we've got some. What have we got? We've got lemon drizzle. We've got. Have you been fed yet, by the way?
Yes.
Yeah, well,
but not cake.
Not cake. Okay, we can fix that. So. There is some lemon drizzle, there's coffee sponge, there is carrot cake, super popular. There's millionaire shortbread, there may be some chocolate brownies left. And you can obviously order anything else, but if you stay where you are, if you can take the order from the table, that way we know where to get it back to. In the meanwhile, if you want to go and have some fresh air, or if it's too warm anyway and you want to open the window, please do. But before you go any further, could you make one more big ripple for this boy, John Hart? Thank you.
Thank you.
If you switch it over, it's got mine and John's set. It's got saving the trees.
Oh, yeah. Oh. Well, that was an opportunity to wipe him out in some way or another.
That's me. Ed, can you check the lights? Have a game on the lights. Is this like this? Good.
But if you're all comfortable and would like to take your seats again, welcome back to part two. There's actually a part two and a bit, or a third part, I think, at the end of this. That's the plan. Who knows? It's kind of really interesting. Billy, who is now 17, came here when he was 14 for the first time. And yeah, time flies. Guess what? It gets quicker. It really does. Billy, I'm really pleased and proud. I am proud, but I'm excited for the fact he's actually just won a scholarship to the Royal College of Music, age 17, yeah. And as an anecdote to that, there was a girl who was sitting down watching Billy from his last performance here, and she said, well, I went to the Royal College of Music. And then she looked at the TV screen again, and she said, he doesn't need to go. However, it's really going to be really good for networking and all of that. Anyway, listen, boys and girls, would you please welcome back to the stage and make a big noise for Mr. Billy Wattman.
Thank you very much. Thank you. All right, just check, we can all hear me in all the rooms. All right. So, my name is Billy. I am technically a classical guitarist, and I kind of dabble with a bit of flamenco kind of stuff as well. But I like to mix it around with a lot of stuff in my own time, and kind of mix it around with a lot of songs that I listen to and songs I've kind of been brought up with. And So I go to I study classical guitar. So I you know, a lot of the stuff is kind of like, you know, stuff like, so something you guys might recognize is the theme song from a film called The Deer Hunter. Is a cavatina. Things like that. thank you. And then you know, with the whole flamenco stuff, that's kind of something I've really found interesting, and something I've kind of, you know, I kind of studied on my own and learned a lot of the techniques on my own. And I find it really fascinating, because like one of the biggest things of flamenco guitar is kind of a thing called a rasqueado, and there's many different ways to kind of play this. And one of my favorite ways is the fam rasqueado. And what this is basically, try and turn so you can see me at the side as well. What's going on is it's a three-stroke thing, so we're having triplets of me going one, two, three. And then kind of with practice, kind of getting faster. And kind of adding pauses. And kind of stuff like that. So that's... Thank you. So that's kind of, you know... a little bit about me, but so what I kind of do is I write a bit of my own stuff, and I mix kind of the classical and the flamenco kind of stuff with a lot of other genres and a lot of the music I listen to and some of my favorites. But I'm gonna start with a couple of originals. This first one was actually the first proper kind of song I ever wrote, and this one's called Queen of the Balkans, kind of flamenco-y rock kind of vibe, so hope you enjoy. Thank you. you very much. Thank you. All right. So one kind of thing I really like to do in my set is kind of explain, because I have quite a few pedals, which the people in this room will be able to see, but I have quite a few pedals at my feet, which kind of help me kind of adjust my sound and add special things to the sound of the guitar, kind of like how John was having his harmonizer to kind of add, you know, his harmonies to his voice. So one of my favorites actually is usually just my reverb pedal, but I've set it so I've got a patch on it so I can do this. So then this you know, really sets the vibe, really mystical, I think. Really suits this venue actually. I mean, kind of like a Pink Floyd-y kind of vibe. But yeah, so enough about the pedals for now. This one is another original one, and this one's called Cryptic. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. All right. So enough of my own tunes. I say that like it's a bad thing. I don't mean it like that. I'm just saying this is the part where I'm actually playing some arrangements. So, so kind of I think with me kind of studying and learning classical guitar, especially, I think the way I kind of look at arranging a song might be slightly different. If I'm perfectly honest, I don't really know why. I think it's just the kind of way I listen to the music and I kind of think about the music. But you know, for example, do we all know the song Eleanor Rigby by the Beatles? Well, a couple of weeks ago, I worked on an arrangement for that. Yeah. So I'll just play a little bit of that to you. Thank you. But yeah, I think it's really nice for the kind of, especially more kind of mellow songs in the classical kind of style. I think it works really well. But just to ask, did anyone here watch the new Queen movie, Bohemian Rhapsody? Yeah, it was great, wasn't it? I loved it. I thought it was brilliant. And I went to go see that, and I remember it was just that kind of scene of. And I watched the live show afterwards as well, and just it was just a complete reminder of how brilliant that moment was when Queen was playing in Rock and Rio, and you know they were playing Love of My Life, just Freddie and Brian, and you know the whole crowd were just singing back, and you know they were all pretty much Brazilian, like they none of them really speak a word of English, but you know I think they did a really really incredible job, and I think that's such an incredible thing to watch, and you know. Just really, really hit me as a musician as well. So coming home, watching that, I went home, I sat down, and I decided to do an arrangement of this tune. So this is a really, definitely up there on some of my favorites of Queen songs. And so yeah, this is Love of My Life. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. All right. So this next one is originally by a guy called Mason Williams. And this was actually rearranged by an incredible guitarist called Tommy Emmanuel. And I've kind of taken my own little take on his arrangement of that. But when I first heard this, I learned this quite a few years ago. And try to put a little bit of my own edge on it. But so yeah. This one's classical gas. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. All right. So as I was saying earlier, I really like to explain the gear, kind of so it kind of gives you guys an understanding and also gives me something to talk about in between songs. So, so for this next one, I'm going to be using my loop pedal. And for anyone that doesn't know what a loop pedal is, basically it records what I play and then plays it over and over again. So for example, if I recorded something like this, basically that'll just keep playing over and over again. And then I can record another layer on the top of that. See how a loop pedal works. Thank you. Yeah, so this one's from a genre probably the furthest away you can get from classical guitar, which is disco. This one is originally a tune from the 70s, and this is by a band called Boney M, and this is Rasputin. Thank you very much. Thank you. Okay, so for this next one, I'll be playing the ukulele. Yes. Okay, so this is one of my favorite Beatles songs. Probably doesn't really suit playing on the ukulele, but I'm gonna do it anyway. And yeah, this is While My Guitar Gently Weeps, but I'm gonna be using a couple of effects and a couple of my loop pedal as well. And I like to call this one While My Ukulele Gently Shreds. So hope you like it.
Thank you.
For the record, I accidentally pressed something on the ground and now I don't know what I did wrong. All right, got it. Okay. So this one's going to be my last one. Oh. And for this one, I want to ask you all a favor. Now, if you may have noticed that I don't sing during my set. that is the favor. I want all of you to sing for this one. Yes, I do. No, I do. I do. I do. I want you all to sing as loud as you can. And there's no excuse not to sing along, because everyone knows the words to this song. So I just want to give a check. Can we hear a big noise from the back room, from the Zen Den? Oh, it's good, good, good. From downstairs. Oh, yeah. And up here. Woo! I don't know whether it was just that I was in the room, but I think you guys are winning. No, I'm joking. So, there's no excuse not to sing along for this song, because everyone knows the words to this song. And if you don't, well, you should. It's sad. It's very sad. You break my heart. And this is one of my favorite songs, probably of all time. I think this is one of the best songs ever. And this is a song by Queen, and this is Bohemian Rhapsody. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. All right. So, just before the next bit, I just want to say, I kind of was meant to say this earlier, but I kind of got carried away and forgot. But I was meant to say after the Tubular Bells bit, I was going to say like, oh yeah, I can't play Tubular Bells live, but I have it on. I've done it on my CD. So, yeah. If any of you are interested, just come and find me after the gig and. Yeah, I'll give you any details you need on that. And then I just wanted to say another thing about, because Richard was saying, obviously, I'm going to Royal College this year in September. And then, thank you. And obviously, I'm going to be very heavily in debt. And I've worked out, it's going to take roughly 8,000 CDs for me to sell. So I just thought I'd let you guys know. But, yeah, just before I end, I want to say a massive thank you to Richard. I want to say a massive thank you to Ed on the sound. You've been incredible. And I want to invite John back up to the stage. We're going to play a couple more tunes. And I would say I really enjoyed your set, John. I thought it was incredible, as always. And
right, how are we going to do this?
You're going to sit on that chair? I'll move along. Just while we faffle about with this. we're not going to tell you what tunes we're going to play. We're just going to play them. And we'll see if you guys recognize them. It's something me and John have been working on for months and months. Yeah. So much hardcore work has gone into this. So yeah, hope you guys enjoy. Thank you. Yeah, so the guy that was hosting the venue yesterday kind of came up to me after I'd finished my set and John was playing. He's like, oh, do you know I Just Called to Say, like Stevie Wonder? I was like, oh yeah, I know that song. He was like, yeah, we're gonna do it at the end. And I was like, wait. And he's like, he was having none of it. We were doing it. So then so I come back on stage after me and John did our thing, and then he's there with Sam. He comes back on the stage and he's like, John kind of finds out about it just before I start doing it. And yeah, it was great though. It worked out really well. So we'll see how this one goes down. I don't really know this song very well, but I think I kind of know it, but I've definitely never played it. I think this is really where the test of my musical skills come in. So, I think I'm gonna not say what this one is, so if it goes wrong, I can just say it was improvised. Thank you.
Will you come back? Next Saturday. Listen, thank you all so very much for coming tonight. If you want to stay and have a drink, that's very cool. We're going to clear up around you. If you want to hang on to a glass, let us know. If you're going downstairs, take a glass with you. It helps clear up. If you want to tip the guys here, please do. They absolutely love it. And thank you, Ed. Thank you, guys. Thank you all for turning out, because this is great best job. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Check 1, 2. I think I'll just say about mine and John's CDs again. So we'll come around with those. I forgot to mention I also have USB sticks, nice wooden ones as well, and John also has them.
Yeah. Children, university.
And yeah, I mean, you know, the CDs are great. We both have about 3,000 each. So